Hey foodies, welcome back to our channel guys. So as you must have seen in the title, today's cake is made out of rava and also we have not used any egg here guys. So a lot of you must have seen a lot of cakes being baked during this lockdown, but some of us will not like eggs in our cakes and some of us will want to eat healthier version of these cakes without using maida and all. So if you're someone like that, then this cake is right up your alley. This cake is made out of rava or suji, and trust me guys, I mean when I first thought of making this cake I was a little bit hesitant because I didn't know how it would turn out, but it came out really good. It was tasting very nice and I hope you also try out this recipe. So if you want to know how to make this rava or suji cake, so just keep watching this recipe guys. If you're new here, you're watching Get Set and Cook with Pratima and Chandina. So to make this, I've taken about 1 cup of suji or 1 cup of rava. I'm going to add that into a bowl. To this I'm adding in 1/2 cup of powdered sugar. So you have to take in 1/2 cup of granulated sugar and powder it and add all of that into this. Also adding in about 1 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda and about a pinch or 1/4 teaspoon of salt. Give these dry ingredients a good mix and then we'll get to our wet ingredients here. To this, I'm going to add in milk. I've taken about 1/2 cup of milk here, which I'm going to add in gradually and mix it. You want to do this so that there won't be any lumps. If you add in your wet ingredients gradually, you can ensure that there won't be any lumps, guys. That's the reason we do this. Keep adding in the milk and giving it a good mix. Now, to this I'm also going to add in some oil. Here I'm taking about 5 tablespoons of oil. Add this in and give it a good mix until the oil and the remaining batter combines well. Once it looks something like this, you want to allow it to rest for 30 minutes. Now since we're using rava here, it needs to bloom guys, so let it rest. In the meanwhile, let's preheat a kadai for this. As you can see, I'm not using an oven or a pressure cooker to make this. So if you don't have either of them, you can use any vessel that is a little bit bigger. Add some salt or sand into that. Keep a small stand and cover a lid and let it preheat on high heat for about 10 to 15 minutes. Once our rava mixture has rested for about 30 minutes, I'm adding in some vanilla essence here, about 3-4 teaspoon of vanilla essence, and I'm giving it a good mix. So most of us think, what is a substitute for egg guys? It's curd. So look at this, I'm adding in about 1/4 cup of curd and I'm folding it in. Trust me guys, most of us must think, how can curd taste well with all these things? And I had the same doubt too, but it really tastes well. It makes the cake really soft and you won't even notice that there's curd there. So if you want to avoid egg, it's the best thing you can do. After that, I've greased a cake tin and I'm adding in the mixture. So I like to add tutti fruttis to my cakes, so I've coated them with little maida, very little, like about 1/4 spoon, and I'm adding it in. We do this to ensure that they don't sink. Now I'm going to keep this in the preheated kadai and let it bake for about 40 to 45 minutes or until the toothpick comes out clean. Yeah, the tutti frutti sand guys. Unfortunately, this was a fail, but usually this trick works. Take out the butter paper. After you have allowed the cake to cool for about 30 to 35 minutes, and it's so soft. Really, it was so good to eat. I did not expect that this would turn out this well. So if you want to give this a try, definitely go ahead. It's something different and I'm sure you'll like it. This tasted great with Nutella, by the way. So if you like to eat Nutella with everything, you can do that with this cake too. It was so soft and it was delicious, guys. So if you want to have any other options instead of maida, this cake is definitely for you. Please subscribe to my channel and thank you for watching.